have a list, and the first one is strengthening muscle and bone. So this is, again, besides the emotional component, the mental component, also physical component. And Joann, if you can speak about these.
Sure. The strengthening muscle and bone will be very specific to the style of yoga that you choose. For example, if you choose to do a restorative class where you spend the majority of the time laying down on the mat, then it's not going to really help in terms of the muscle strengthening and strengthening bone mineral density, because for that you need to do weight-bearing exercise. So if you pick a style of yoga, for example, like power yoga or hatha yoga class, then that would be helpful for improving balance, improving bone mineral density, and strengthening the muscles. Mm-hmm. So if you're looking for that, then the style of class that you choose is going to be very important. In terms of improving joint range of motion, long-term studies haven't really shown that doing some sort of flexibility exercise can help long-term range of motion.
Right.
But short-term, it can help to improve the range of motion, especially we see it mostly in a lot of our patients who have undergone surgery.
Right.
For example, if they have a mastectomy and maybe they have cording underneath the arms and they have limited range of motion in the shoulders, or from radiation therapy, from having their arms being placed in a specific position for a long period of time, sometimes they may get frozen shoulder. And so with doing these exercises over time, they do have more, not saying complete range of motion, but at least less pain and a little bit more movement than they had before.
When you say frozen shoulder, is that it's not moving, or it just stays in one place?
It will be limited range of motion. So for example, they may be able to come to 90 degrees, but they can't go above the shoulder.
Okay.
And that they would have to work out at physical therapy, but can be very painful to go through. So it's important to try to, what we try to do is to encourage patients as they're going through treatment to stay as active as possible and to continue to stretch during treatment to limit the amount of impingement or any type of pain or restrictions that they may have after treatment.
Which also helps with fatigue that often comes with having cancer or you're in recovery and you're in remission, even mm-hmm. you still have that fatigue that follows you even months or sometimes years afterwards.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.